and this will be followed by a speech from our guest of honour. Finally, the Vice-Chancellor will confer your awards upon you, and that's when you'll be able to put your mortarboards on your head and cheer loudly. The ceremony closes once the academic procession has left. I'm getting to that bit in a minute. Once the ceremony is underway and you've not yet gone across the stage, if you think that you're going to need to go to the toilet, please try and hold on. Otherwise, you might miss your turn going across the stage. If you really are desperate, then please talk to Marshall, who'll be able to tell you if you have enough time or not. Once you've been across the stage, then you can actually slip out to go to the toilet before coming back to your seat. Please switch mobile phones off, and this will not disturb the ceremony. You can take photographs, but please remain in your seats and don't stand up to block other people's view or stand in the aisles. Within 10 minutes of the ceremony starting, we'll be asking the first students to move from their seats and go onto the stage. Don't panic, a marshal will tell you exactly when you need to move and where to. You'll leave your seat to your left and then go to the end of the row and move down the aisle towards the stage. Please leave all of your belongings underneath your chairs. As you leave your row, your name will be checked to make sure that you're in the right order. Please come down the aisle and ensure that you remain in that order. That's the order that you're seated in now. This is very important. At the bottom of the steps, your name will be checked again. As you approach this stage, your gown will be checked. And then you'll join a small line at the entrance to the stage, which is just here. You'll be called onto the edge of the stage, and this time your name will be checked again by one of the marshals called the launcher. Wait until your name is called by the senior academic on the stage who's reading from the lectern. At this point, we've been able to control what happens to you, but from then on, it's up to you. So please don't creep, jog or sprint. Just move at a steady pace across the stage and hopefully you'll remember how to walk. You will stop twice, the first time being to shake the hand of our guest of honour and then to be given your scroll. Don't forget to wave to your family and friends because this is your moment of celebration and it's theirs too. And make the most of it and expect to be cheered. However, please do not take any selfies. We're now going to give you a quick demonstration of how to walk across the stage. Am I calling your name out? Yeah. Alan Tree. Please pay attention to this. This is how you exit the stage, and you need to go up that aisle there where Alan's actually walking now. There will be marshals to guide you, so just please follow their instructions. During the ceremony, we do ask people to remain in their seats, so again, please don't stand up and block other people's views, and definitely don't stand in ours because this might block the motion of the students coming up onto the stage. So as a quick recap, please check that you're in the right seat, which has the number on, which is on your ticket. Once again, this is very important. When you leave your seat to come onto the stage, please leave all of your belongings and the mortarboard under your seat. Then, once that's done, it's time to celebrate, so please cheer your friends and make lots of noise. Once again, congratulations, and please do enjoy yourselves.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the University of Sunderland's Academic Awards ceremony. Can all of our guests please ensure that your mobile phones are either switched off or switched to silent? You're all welcome to take photos and video throughout the ceremony, but we do ask that everybody stays in their seat while you're doing it, because if you stand up to catch the moment, you might be blocking the view for somebody whose loved one is just about to cross the stage too. The actual conferment of all of the awards is at the very end of the ceremony, so we do ask people to stay in their seats until the ceremony is over. In the unlikely event of a fire or other emergency, there'll be an announcement made over this PA system, and stadium stewards will guide you out of here into a place of safe assembly. And finally, this is a time of celebration and a time for you to show appreciation for the achievement of our graduates here today. So please, do feel free to show this when they cross this stage in just a few minutes' time and make sure that they can hear your applause and your cheers. We hope that you all enjoy the ceremony. And now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please all stand? Please be seated. Would you please welcome to the stage, to open our ceremony, members of the University Choir, Dodici Voce.
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid, oh, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. Oh, darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Stand by me.
If the sky that we look upon
should tumble and fall,
you've got a friend in me.
Sure crumble in the
we're sea. All in this together.
I won't cry,
I won't cry, shed a tear.
What a wonderful friend. It means no worries, Hakuna. darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me.
Oh,
stand by me.
Ticket for the long way round, to bottle of whiskey for the way, and I
sure would like some sweet company,
cause I'm leaving tomorrow. What do you say? When I'm gone,
when I'm gone,
when I'm gone,
when I'm gone.
You're gonna miss me when I'm gone.
You're gonna miss me,
you're gonna miss me by my hair. You're gonna miss me everywhere. Oh, you're gonna miss me when I'm gone.
I've got my ticket for the long way round, the one with the prettiest of views.
It's got mountains, it's got rivers, it's got sights to give you shivers, but it sure would be prettier
with you when I'm gone.
When I'm gone.
When I'm gone.
When I'm gone.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor, Mrs. Shirley Atkinson, to welcome you and to open the ceremony.
Good afternoon, everyone. Distinguished guests, colleagues, friends, families and graduates, it is my very great pleasure to welcome you to the University's Academic Awards Ceremony for the Faculty of Health Sciences and Wellbeing and the Faculty of Arts and Creative Industries. My thanks go to the team at this fantastic venue who work tirelessly to make our graduations so special. On the platform with me today, I am delighted to welcome our esteemed honorary graduates, governors, and academic staff from the faculties. I would like to share with you some of the university achievements over the past period, which I hope will make you feel proud to be associated with an institution recognised for its warmth, its friendliness, and exceptional support for students. Earlier this year, we were awarded a silver rating in the Teaching Excellence Framework Assessment, placing us alongside other high-performing universities such as York, Warwick, Sheffield, Manchester, King's College London, Bristol, and Durham. The expert panel of assessors highlighted our excellent engagement with employers in the development of relevant academic programmes. The panel also congratulated us, and I quote, on an institutional culture that facilitates and encourages excellent teaching. The Silver Award is fitting as the university celebrates its 25th anniversary this year. And the teaching accolade sits alongside our performance in the most recent Research Excellence Framework exercise, where 10 areas of our research are officially rated as world-leading. Our academics are involved in relevant and impactful research across a diverse range of topics. And we have seen a further rise in the prospects for our graduates. Figures released in July show that over 94% of our graduates are in work or further study within 6 months of leaving the institution. Investment in our facilities has continued apace with the opening of our new Centre for Enterprise and Innovation to support businesses and entrepreneurial graduates in the city, and the opening of our fabulous simulated learning environment, the Living Lab, which provides cutting-edge facilities for innovative working practice in healthcare. The university also has a new School of Nursing, with a further investment of £10 million planned for health facilities over the next 12 months. In addition, we are making significant investment in advanced manufacturing and engineering in both research and teaching facilities as we look to support the region's economic strategy and the continued demand for graduate skills. We have brought together our cultural assets, the National Glass Centre and the Northern Gallery for Contemporary Art, under the umbrella of a new culture company, and we are leading the way and connecting culture with place and communities. And of course, as a university, we are heavily involved in the city's bid to be UK City of Culture 2021. Our hugely successful and important work in teacher education, social sciences, business, law, and tourism continues to deliver real impact. In March, we opened our new campus in Hong Kong, and we now have three campuses, here in Sunderland, in Canary Wharf in London, and now in Hong Kong. We offer opportunities for our students to study in all three locations, and I am thrilled that 250 students from Sunderland took the opportunity to spend time at our campus in London over the summer months. We are, of course, recognised as a global university, with many thousands of international students studying with us either here in Sunderland, in London, in Hong Kong, or with our partner institutions in 17 countries across the world. And in our Faculty of Health Sciences and Wellbeing, under the excellent leadership of Professor Tony Alabaster, the last year has seen many highlights. These include, of course, our new School of Nursing, which was shortlisted in the Student Nursing Times Awards, an impressive accolade given the school has only been open for just over a year. And we were also very pleased that the university was ranked fifth in the country for nursing in the 2018 Guardian League table. The faculty welcomed Professor Lisa Bayliss-Pratt, Chief Nurse of Health Education England, to open our new Living Lab facility, and Dr. Stephen McGregor, one of the UK's leading fitness experts, who is credited with transforming the elite end of professional sport. And he praised the contemporary relevance of sports science research here at Sunderland, where his own career began 21 years ago. We are also extremely delighted to announce that with the support from our health partners across the region, the university has submitted a proposal to open a new medical school. There is a clear need for additional medical training places in the region, and we are ideally placed to fulfil this need, building on our established success in the areas of medical science, pharmacology, and nursing education. And our other faculty here with us this afternoon, our Faculty of Arts and Creative Industries, under the excellent leadership of Professor Arabella Pluvier, have also had an excellent year. In September, the BBC established its first base in the city for many years at our media hub. Students now work alongside the BBC's broadcast and online journalists and have access to a rolling series of contracts for graduates. The BBC's arrival is a ringing endorsement of the university's commitment to excellence in the training of journalists. Across the faculty, staff are involved with Creative Fuse Northeast. This Arts and Humanities Research Council-funded project is uniting the research excellence of the five Northeast universities to unlock the potential of the digital and technology sectors across the region. And there was huge cause for celebration when staff from the faculty received a collaborative award for teaching excellence from the Higher Education Academy, justified recognition for the role of team working in the Northeast Photography Network. But of course, today is your day, our graduates. This is the moment to reflect on your personal achievement and to celebrate with friends and family. And at this point, I would like to thank you for choosing to study with us at the University of Sunderland. Your success is our success, and you make us very proud. On the subject of thanks, I would like to acknowledge and thank all of the parents, friends, and relatives here today, without whose support, I have no doubt your time here would have been a little more difficult. And of course, to the marvellous, dedicated staff of this university, I offer my sincere thanks. To all of our academic and support staff, your engagement with our students, your unwavering support for their aspirations, and your profound belief that student success is our ultimate goal is both humbling and inspiring. And so, class of 2017, in this our silver anniversary year, celebrate this moment, look forward to the future with pride, enthusiasm, and passion. I hope we have both challenged and inspired you. I hope you leave us feeling more confident, more resilient, and prepared for whatever life now holds. We hope we have helped you enjoy experiences and meet people you never imagined possible. We hope you have made enduring connections and built lifelong friendships through your time here. Most importantly, we hope we have shown you new ways of thinking and problem solving that will enable you to become the leaders of tomorrow. You are our tomorrow makers. Remember to stay open and receptive to new thinking, curious and creative, and resilient and purposeful when times are not so straightforward. Do keep in touch. Remember, our Careers and Employability Service is open to you for 3 years after graduation. And of course, we hope you will join our active alumni community. But for now, remember to clap and cheer your friends as they cross the platform and enjoy your moment in the spotlight. It is so very well deserved. And then please enjoy the rest of the day with family and friends. Thank you.
I now call upon Professor Tony Alabaster, the Dean of the Faculty of Health Sciences and Wellbeing, to make his presentation.
Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who have been awarded the degree of Master of Science in Environment, Health and Safety. Emily O'Connor. Kofi Antwi. Carl Welpdale. Blessing Alasigwe. Ogechukwu Christopher. For the Master of Science in Nursing, Stephanie Dobson. Abiola Alawuwo. Also receiving the Eden Ravenscroft Prize, Ugochukwu Ume. Chloe Young. For the Master of Science in Psychological Approaches for Complex Mental Health Issues, Colin Doherty. for the Master of Science in Public Health, Michael Taylor. Catherine Blackburn. Diane Stevenson. Also receiving the Eden Ravenscroft Prize, Una Train. Shamir Mohammed. Anna Minera. Hayley Sharp. For the Master of Science in Sport and Exercise Sciences, Rachel Beatty. Sarah Prudham. Joseph Robinson. Daniel Austin. Elizabeth Martin. Also receiving the Eden Ravenscroft Prize, Claire Topham. Abby Freeman. Vice Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who have been awarded the degree of Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Science. Asadollah Ibrahimi. Elizabeth Bull. Tasmin Razak. Aiva Ritsvikute. Felicia Oladipo. Shahadzia Begum. Jessica Coyle. Adam Tate. For the Bachelor of Science in Biomedical Studies, Craig Seth. For the Bachelor of Science in Exercise, Health and Fitness, Jessica Thompson. Rebecca Ridley. Tracy McFarlane. For the Bachelor of Science in Healthcare Science, Cardiac Physiology, Abdirahman Farah. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who have been awarded the degree of Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Eunice Odiasi. Rumbid Zai Seeker. Ike Chukwu Ezibigwe. Stephen Azima. Halima Ayodel. Abisola Dalamola. Fidelis Ube. Segun Fashoanri. Ahumwan Obaseki. Esogini Utimoe. For the Bachelor of Science in Physiological Sciences, Mahadi Moseni. Rebecca Woodhouse. For the Bachelor of Science in Sports Coaching, Miles Hubbard. Beth Gibson. Danielle Turner. And Nicole Davis.
I now call upon Professor Arabella Pluvier, Dean of the Faculty of Arts and Creative Industries, to make her presentation.
Vice Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following who have been awarded the degree of Master of Arts in Ceramics: Ruth Ann Brenner. Richard Oliver. Master of Arts in Curating, Fikia Heiji Ibrahim. Jose Forrest Tennant. Master of Arts in Design, Salome Bakara. Gary Nicholson. Danielle Waterworth. Johanna Ungerheuer. Lauren Royal. Woo! Parkin. Lauren Amy Davis. Yasmin Curry. Jin Shun Yap. Jingluan Li Yu. Rachel Ann Irvin. Yunran Fan. Master of Arts in Fine Art, Angela Jane Kennedy. Andrew George Holder. Alex Sophie Sanderson. Emily Cummings. Leticia Diogo. Musen Musavi. Sarah Louise Turgus. Kathleen Nora Hodgson Calder. Jessica Ellen Ballantyne. Master of Arts in Glass, Susan Jane Delbridge. Louis Hope Darling. Yuan Zhang. Master of Arts in Journalism, Charlotte Ann O'Neill. Master of Arts in Media Production, Film and Television, Olukoya Olusegun Aejie. Master of Arts in Magazine Journalism, Stephanie Victoria Farnsworth. Charlotte Jasmine Emily Lloyd. Alice Rose Hewson. Master of Arts in Photography, Christopher Thomas Younger. Michael James Daglish. Saskia Marianne Munden. Sarah Ann Parker. Darren Milburn. Lele Kay. Pauline Pentany. Tianyi Ren. Master of Arts in Public Relations, Lauren J. Old. Adam Ely. Laura Jane Chester. Chris Thornley. Daniel William Robinson. Daniel David Kennedy. Radu Tudor Tamas. Zoe Elizabeth Cooper. Yelena Pasenko. Bridget McLean. Alice Midgley. Master of Arts in Radio, Emma Casson. Jonathan William Goldsmith. Master of Arts in Sports Journalism, James Christopher Bell. Stephen Joseph Ramage. David Joseph Barwise. Postgraduate Diploma in Radio, Nicholas Borthwick. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who has been awarded the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Advertising and Design. Coral McQuillan. Bachelor of Arts in Broadcast Journalism, Angela Burns. Bachelor of Arts in Fashion Journalism, Catherine Smith. Amy Mond. Bachelor of Arts in Fashion Product and Promotion, Octavia Alexandra Brown. Georgia Valanidou. Bachelor of Arts in Glass and Ceramics, Dawid Jaeger Stroni. Ruth Crowther. Bachelor of Arts in Music, Connor Ramshaw. Bachelor of Arts in Sports Journalism, James Joslin. Sean Butcher. Joshua Matthew Carr. Elliot Howie. Vice Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following who has been awarded the degree of Master of Arts in International Management, Lubna Javedi. Vice Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following graduates, Francis Esnegu. Mercy Alida. Chukwuma Uduku. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting Barry Lihe for the award of the University of Sunderland Alumni Achiever of the Year. Barry Lihe graduated in 1996 with a bachelor's degree in sports science and has become since an industry expert in international business and manufacturing. As managing director of the largest UK manufacturer of outdoor children's playground equipment, Playdale Playgrounds Limited, Barry grew the business from £5 million to £15 million in 7 years. When austerity hit the industry, Barry had a plan not only to survive, but to build a platform for future success and led Playdale into the exports markets. Barry took over 450 flights and lived outside the UK for over 2 years to ensure the future of more than 100 employees at Playdale. Now the company operates distributors in 46 companies and has survived a UK market contraction of 40%. Playdale were named UK Export Champion, Family Business Manufacturer of the Year, a National SME Exporter of the Year and Commonwealth Export Champion. In 2017, Barry received an MBE in the Queen's Birthday Honours for his services to export and international trade. He said, "I dedicate this honour to the hard work of my team and proof that great things happen to the most ordinary people who aspire to be the best. An award that I would never have achieved if I had not had that grounding at the University of Sunderland." In recognition for his exceptional career, Barry has been named an Alumni Achiever of the Year 2017.
I now call upon the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, Professor Michael Young, to present those who have been awarded higher degrees by research.
Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who has been awarded the degree of Master of Philosophy. Lilahom Ben KLA's project looked at the relationship between cultural attitudes to exposing infants to nuts and the incidence of peanut allergy. She used a questionnaire to ask parents if they fed their children nuts at an early age and if their children suffered allergies. She compared the general UK population, where the historical evidence has been to avoid peanuts, to Libyan populations, both within Libya and the UK, where the culture is to introduce peanuts and groundnuts to infants at around 3 months. The research showed that the Libyan culture of exposing infants to peanuts resulted in significantly less peanut allergy. This work supports the growing body of evidence that suggests that early exposure to allergy-causing food helps the immune system to become more tolerant and reduces the chance of developing extreme allergic reactions. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in asking Dr. Noel Carter, Director of Studies for this research degree, to present Dr. Lilahom Bin Kael for the award of Master of Philosophy. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who has been awarded the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. Philip Emeka Anyanwu's research examined anti-malarial drug use behaviours in Nigeria. Malaria remains a global health issue, with the burden unevenly borne by the disadvantaged of developing countries around the world. This study adopted a social epidemiological stance in exploring existing anti-malarial drug use behaviours that can promote drug resistance in Nigeria. The resistance-promoting drug use behaviours identified in this study were the practice of mixing drugs for malaria treatment, presumptive treatment of malaria, the sharing of anti-malarial courses, and saving anti-malarial drugs for future use. When malaria symptoms are experienced, socio-economic factors such as educational level, type of settlement, and household income tend to determine the treatment behaviours and therefore inform and determine the experience of malaria. Several publications have resulted from this study, including a conference presentation sponsored by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in asking Dr. John Fulton, Director of Studies for this research degree, to present Dr. Philip Emeka Anyanwu for the award of Doctor of Philosophy. Margajata Goshka Bialik's research related to the assemblage and interpretation of views concerning the perception of inner space in sculpture occupied by inclusions. The focus was to investigate methods of combining two materials, metal and transparent materials such as glass, for creative use, and specifically to introduce transparent materials into sculpture. The inclusion of metal elements inside glass sculptures offers compelling visual impact and metaphoric advantages. For example, metal figures can be made to float within the glass head forms to create inner worlds. Through studio-based experiments and dialogues with materials scientists, this research has developed and documented new possibilities in the application of metal inclusions for creative practice. In particular, the use of nickel, nickel alloys and lead alloys in hot poured glass formed in moulds. The subject of this research offers a model for cooperation between scientists and artists. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in asking Professor Kevin Petrie, Director of Studies for this research degree, to present Dr. Margajata Goshka Bielik for the award of Doctor of Philosophy. Julie Denton's art-led research was focused on encapsulating complex flame-worked glass components within the interior and on the surface of sand-cast glass objects. The research developed new techniques and enhanced old methods associated with hot glass inclusions. These methods offer the potential to create an inner world within glass sculptures. The practical problems associated with the encapsulation process are distortion, misplacement, and cracking of encapsulated glass objects. The research addressed these issues through studio-based testing and developed two new approaches, transitional inclusion and floating inclusion. A new series of artworks were produced to demonstrate and further develop these new processes. This investigation contributed to new knowledge by presenting new encapsulation methods for use in glass with further application in studio production. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in asking Mr. Colin Rennie, Director of Studies for this research degree, to present Dr. Julie Denton for the award of Doctor of Philosophy. Kathleen Moroney's research investigates stillness as movement, explored and exploited through an interdisciplinary study of ceramics and dance. Exercises consistent with buto, a Japanese dance form, are employed as an exploratory tool to facilitate a broader interpretation of stillness as motion through a corporeal processing of concepts such as time and space. This study maps a path to practice that involves constructing a material bridge linking two disciplines, ceramics and dance, through similarities and varying approaches to a shared area of concern, movement in time and space. Kathleen's research contributes to the discourse on interdisciplinary practice, specifically relating to ceramics and dance. It provides a transferable model of research that merges two fields of practice, broadening and intensifying the experience of learning through a combined kinesthetic, visual, and cognitive approach. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in asking Professor Andrew Livingston, Director of Studies for this research degree, to present Dr. Kathleen Moroney for the award of Doctor of Philosophy. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in presenting the following, who has been awarded the degree of professional doctorate. Margaret Orange's research study examined drug-related death and serious incidents in one clinical service provider in the specialist setting of addictions. Drug-related death and serious incident is a key concern not only to policymakers, but to drug treatment commissioners and providers, as well as being responsible for significant impact on families and communities. Using an action research methodology, an understanding of the national context, and an analysis of local incidents was gained. The outcome of the research is a model of knowledge management underpinned by evidence-based safety approaches not routinely used in NHS settings, which creates a constructive approach to learning and dissemination. A web-based tool to ensure this learning is not lost has been developed, thus developing and maintaining organisational memory and a learning culture. The work has been disseminated significantly to communities of practice, locally, regionally and nationally, within the National Harm Reduction Network and Public Health England consultation. Vice-Chancellor, I have pleasure in asking Dr. John Fulton, Director of Studies for this research degree, to present Dr. Margaret Anne Orange for the award of Professional Doctorate.
Vice-Chancellor, Chairman, I'd like to take this opportunity to present three final graduates. Geraldine Orgy. Omobalanle Adebayo. Chinemelum Unuchuka. I now call upon Richard Oliver to give a vote of thanks on behalf of the student body.
Phone. Vice-Chancellor, Chairman, on behalf of all students graduating this afternoon from the Faculty of Art and Creative Industries and the Faculty of Health Science and Wellbeing, we propose the vote of thanks. I would like to thank all of the staff for the university who taught and supported us through the years of study. Few of us wouldn't be here today without the help, but if it wasn't for the support of our families and loved ones, who have been there for us throughout. Can you tell I'm nervous? As we all move forward, hopefully in an exciting new future, the University's Alumni Association works hard to maintain contact with all the graduates, keep us all together. So let's keep in touch through our online community. I think all I need to say now is best wishes to all my fellow graduates. Amazing. And thank you to you all.
I now call upon Mr. John Mowbray, Chairman of the University's Board of Governors, to address you.
Honoured guests, ladies and gentlemen, and award winners, good afternoon. I'm going to tell you a story, and if I may, I'll get back to you later, if that's okay. If you leave this stadium and you walk out the front door, cross over the car park, down the little hillside onto the riverside, you'll find a big metal cover. It's about this big. And it marks the spot where in 1826 they started to dig the mine that became Weymouth Colliery, which used to stand where the stadium stands today. I want you to imagine, and on that cover it says, into the mouth of hell. It also said only a madman would go down here. But imagine, nearly 200 years ago, somebody was thinking about digging that shaft, and then it spread from there underneath where we are now and went right out to sea. Can you imagine who thought of that, who did it, who sunk the shaft and got on with it, and the people who worked in there for many, many years afterwards? So quite extraordinary things happen in Sunderland. If you stood on the riverside and looked left and right, ignore the bends in the river, but not that long ago you'd say it was full of ships, because Sunderland was the largest shipbuilding town in the world. And you'd see ships from Sunderland all over the world, travelling around the world. My grandfather helped to build ships, and my father, further up the river, helped to build cranes. So different stories, but people in those days were doing extraordinary things in Sunderland. The Vice-Chancellor mentioned the bid to be the UK City of Culture in 2021, and we'll find out next week, so cross everything you can for the next fortnight or so. If you look at social media or the media, you may have seen a video which has been going around called We Are Makers, and that captures some of that past, but it also looks to the future, because it recognises that our best days are still to come. And that's what I want to get onto today. Before I do that, the video itself was made by two companies. They both worked together, and they were both organisations made up of alumni from this university. It's an amazing, emotional film. And they tendered for the video. They didn't get it because they came from this university. It's because they put the best bid in against some pretty stiff competition. So extraordinary people from this university doing things which have been recognised. Barry's story today, extraordinary. Sunderland University at the heart of that. And I didn't know that story till I just heard that, the same as you. An amazing story of somebody wanting to succeed and coming from this extraordinary place. So what are we doing now? We're making videos, we've talked about that, we're making cars, we're doing software, making music, glass and ceramics, and a whole range of other things which you cover today in terms of the different awards that different people have got. The other thing that the video says is we are makers, and what's the future? And I said that bit about the best is yet to come. But it also said, we are making a noise. And a noise covers virtually everything that we're doing. What I'd like to say to you, coming back to today, is you have now joined that group of people who have done extraordinary things in Sunderland and in Sunderland University. You've done something very, very special. The video was called We Are Makers. It was made by people from the university. But you come through our university and you are the tomorrow makers. You have the opportunity to make everyone's tomorrow. You've got the opportunity to change things, to make things happen for better. That's all in front of you because of the work that you've done up to now in your life. And wherever you are in your journey, this is now your time to step off the platform and do great things. So my plea to you is, I've used the word extraordinary a few times deliberately because I want you to remember that. And I want you to do extraordinary things in your life, in your work, in your projects, in whatever you do. And as you do that and you take that forward because of what you've learned through this university, I'd like you to think about doing the extra things as well. And those are the things that make a difference, that change society, which change people's lives and help others. So please think of that as you go forward. So we're making a noise, and now it's your turn to make a noise. So could I ask you to stand up, please? not everybody, just the award winners, the graduates. And I'm going to use that word extraordinary again because you've had extraordinary support from all of these people over here. You've had shoulders to cry on when you needed to. You've probably had taxi rides to goodness knows where, all over the place. There may have been some cash support along the way, and emotional support, lots of other things. So what I'd like you to do now is make a really big noise just to say thank you to this side of the room. But bear in mind, I'm judging you against the graduates we had this morning, so a bit louder, please. A bit more, go on. Thank you, you can sit down now. You should leave today with a real sense of pride. Everyone else is proud of you. You should leave here, and you should never let that extraordinary slip from your lives in whatever you do. So remember that in everything you do as you go forward. Now, whether you're from Sunderland and you're staying here, and we hope you do, or whether you're from other parts of the country, other parts of the world, and you've enjoyed your time in Sunderland and you want to stay here, we hope you do, it doesn't matter. Whatever you do in the future, don't forget extraordinary, and don't forget this extraordinary city by the sea. Enjoy the rest of your day, and good luck in your future. Thank you.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to address you and to confer the awards on those students presented here today and those students who are qualified but who are unable to be present.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Lovely ceremony. Thank you all for attending and clapping. Richard, I don't know where Richard is. Thank you for that vote of thanks on behalf of the students. Very apt, very appropriate. Well said, thank you. That's okay. Sometimes brief is good. And John Mowbray, who just spoke to you, is chair of our Board of Governors, and we are very, very fortunate in this institution to have some absolutely superb governors who support us behind the scenes, and some of whom are sitting on the platform amongst you and behind me. And John used the word extraordinary, and I would say that our board are an extraordinary set of people. And to John and all of those governors, thank you very much for your ongoing support. But final act of this afternoon, would all our graduates please stand and place your mortarboards on your head. Okay, just about there. A little bit of hair tweaking. By the authority vested in me as Vice-Chancellor of the University of Sunderland, I now formally admit you to the degrees, diplomas, and certificates for which you have been presented here today. Many congratulations to you all.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes this afternoon's ceremony. Now, would you please all stand as the procession leaves?